what y'all don't know, Stevie can see.
On the beats.
Stevie can see.
It's just a man.
Can see.
Stevie can see. Stevie flew me to Tobago one time for a jazz festival that he was producing. And I'm on stage with Chris Tucker and Johnny Gill. Chris Tucker and I are Johnny Gill's background dancers. Stevie walks on stage, walks to me, looks me dead in my eye and says, Anthony, get me to a piano. I was like, Stevie, well, hell, if you just walked to me, you could have walked to the piano. He caught himself. He caught himself and had to play it off. And so I took him to the piano and he played. But yes, I did challenge him to a game of one-on-one basketball for a charity event that he does for his son.
And who
for any city youth. He then he said, you know what, Anthony, I don't want to embarrass you one-on-one, so let's just do it free throws. And he won. He won.
Okay.
Stevie Wonder won. I'm telling you, have him on the show. Put stuff in his way.
I bet you he step over.
Go ahead, I know what you're gonna ask me.
You think Stevie Wonder can see?
Listen, I'm saying we lived in a building together on Wilshire Boulevard.
Talk to me, wait, okay. You lived in a building with Stevie?
With Stevie, okay? Oh, you used to have to drive to the bottom underneath to park your car.
Uh-huh.
I'm coming through the first floor that day.
Mm-hmm.
It goes down, because when I got in, I didn't press the button. So it went down first. Stevie got in, I'm standing in the corner, I didn't say nothing. And he looked up and he's like,
what's up?
Big Diesel, and he turned his head. Hit his button and got off.
Come on.
I'm telling you what happened. I don't know if I was smelling from practice that day, but he just turned around. What's up, Diesel? Hit his button. Yeah.
Are you filming this?
Oh, yeah.
I don't want to see this on TV.
All right.
You kidnapped all the ferrets on the East Coast, cut all their fur off, and glued it on your head, boy.
Tell you something, I've been spending my whole life with him thinking he can see. I know he can see. I went to his house. He says, want to hear a new song? I've got it in the car. Come on, go with me.
We go out to the car.
He says, you sit on the passenger side. I'll sit on the driver's side. He goes in. He cranks the car up. He puts the tape in, right? And then he does this.
Whoa, nah.
And starts driving back down the driveway.
No, sir.
And I screamed, said, what are you doing? And he said,
gotcha, bitch.
No, they're all English guys.
Look alike. Y'all sound alike. You know what I mean? No offense, man.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got him.
What are you doing? So good. What are you doing? You FaceTiming someone? Yeah, I mean, it's all good.
James, are you FaceTiming again? You're obsessed with FaceTime.
I used to do a thing about the 10 greatest advantages of being blind. Number 10, you can act like you don't see nothing when you really do.
Huh?
Number 9, you can say you didn't see that when you did.
Oh, hell no.
Number 8 can be like you're saying you don't recognize someone because you didn't see them, but you really did hear that and knew who they were. Number 7 is it?
7, sure.
No, number 7.
Well, you know, you want to make it easy, we can go right to 1.
Number 1. I love that. Number 1.
You can act like Stevie Wonder and get paid.
Yeah. You know where liars go, right?
To hell with Mac Miller.
My brain has been
raped.